guys, it's me, Sidney. Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button because I have tons of content coming. It is officially March Madness. The first video in like the college spectrum that I want to kick it off with is how to have the best college experience. Specifically kind of goes towards freshmen, but like if you haven't been to college before, then this video is totally gonna help you out. Laptop right here because I wrote some notes because I wanted to have it between social and school. So there's two different parts of college that like a lot of people don't really recognize. They're like, oh, I'm going to college, but they forget about the school aspect. So like I'm covering social life and school life. So with that being said, if you're a freshman and you're going into it and you're living in the dorms, there's a lot of things that I want to cover in this video that go towards that, but then there's tons that go towards like partying, school, like classes, like how to make friends. So this video is going to be jam-packed. The summer going into your freshman year, what I highly recommend, this is specific to ASU, but I know other colleges have the exact same thing. You can make friends a couple different ways. So the first way is by using the Devil to Devil app. So they have the schools app, and the schools app specifically like connects you with other ASU students. You can pick the like location, the major, you can, you know, do all that. I, for instance, like use that app a lot. I made a ton of friends, and then by the time I was in the dorms, I felt like I already knew these people. That's a really good way to make friends, using the app. You talk to them all through summer using group chat, Snapchat, you know, those types of things, and that really helps, and I highly recommend it. Even if you're scared, I would just recommend that you post your Snapchat code on there, because then you'll like get a few people that will add you and want to talk to you. But otherwise, just screenshot people's Snap codes that they post on the app and just like start talking to them, be friends with them. So at your orientation, sit next to someone and talk to them. Do not be afraid. At my orientation, I went alone. I went without my family because they make you pay like more money to have your family there, and I was like, I'm not down for that. But a lot of people don't bring their family, so like don't feel pressured to have your parents there, because it is college, it's not high school. You should be able to handle yourself. Because this is college and it's not high school, you have to take your high school mentality and leave it in the past. The moment that you have move-in day, number one, put yourself out there, say hi to people that you met from the app, and just be involved, but leave high school, you know, the way that you acted in high school, out of it, because at the end of the day, no one wants to hang out with people that act like they're from high school. Stay away from people like that also, because those people have a lot of growing up to do and they're not worth the time. The next thing though is learn how to communicate with everyone, because now that you're not in high school and you're in college, you need to learn how to communicate, and it's so hard. Like, I understand how hard it is to communicate, because like when you live with someone, you don't want to like be on their bad side, but communicate with your roommate, communicate with the people that live next door to you, because at the end of the day, like if you're not communicating with them like your frustrations, and then you go straight to your RA, then you're just going to be like not a coward, but like talk to them before you go and complain to your RA. Obviously, if you feel like your roommate's gonna kill you or something, like go tell your RA first, but like try to work things out without bringing in your CA, RA, you know, the person that's higher up. And since we're kind of on the topic of dorm life, do not hook up with people that are in your dorm if you're not okay with seeing them around, because otherwise you're gonna be having a few awkward elevator rides. Personally for me, since I do live at downtown Phoenix campus and I'm an exercise and wellness major, and in the beginning of the semester, not this past semester, but first semester, I did not know that rule. And I am, you know, like I only hooked up with one person, not even like hooked up, if that makes sense. Like we made out, and then he got all weird, and now the elevator rides are just like super awkward because like he just puts his headphones in and like ignores me. But like seriously, if you are not down to have someone like ignore you or have it just be really awkward, like stay away from hooking up with people that are in your dorm that you know that you're gonna see a lot, or that are in your major or you have classes with. Stick to like people that you won't see on a daily basis, if that makes sense. Now we're gonna get to the good juicy stuff. This is like partying, involvement, making friends. So obviously I said Devil to Devil app, but the way that you really make friends is like being involved in other things, like having study groups outside of class and just like talking. So we're gonna get into like that in the school portion, but for now we're gonna talk about like things that you can get involved in, how to experience the real freshman experience. They have events, they have like concerts that are for free, they have, you know, clubs, they have work study, they have movie nights, They have like every Wednesday is DJ in the dining hall. They just have like a ton of different things that you might not know about. They have puppies in the park where you can like pet puppies and just chill. You can make friends through so many different things. So if you want to like go to events, and even if you go alone, you're gonna find someone that you know, and then you'll be able to meet their friends. Or you can just, you know, get involved in clubs. Go to clubs that you are actually passionate about. That's one thing that I wish I would have done last semester, but I'm just so busy as it is that like it's really hard to, you know, get involved in the clubs. But like there's a couple that I am involved in, and I'm really glad I am, because you meet people that are like in the same realm as you, you know, goal-wise, career-wise, just like their side hustle, like what they like to do. So you'll find people that you have things in common with that you can be friends with through those. At the events, usually they have free food or like swag, like t-shirts and, you know, frisbees and hats like this. We had such, oh my gosh, we had an event where they were handing out number one in innovation hats, and I missed it. And I really wanted one of those hats. But so like they always have something that you may not know about. And like they have so many events all the time that are for free. Like sometimes they have massages and stuff like that. So like the big thing is take advantage of everything we have for free on campus, because at the end of the day, like, you are not gonna be able to do it when you graduate, so take advantage of it now. Like, we're able to go to the football games for free. When you're out of college, you're not gonna be able to go to them for free, so take advantage of going to the sporting events and not having to pay. Go to Rush Greek Life. I'm not a huge advocate of Greek Life, obviously, because like I'm not in Greek Life, so you guys don't hear me talk about it that often. But I did Rush for the sororities, and there's two types of Greek Life. There is the multicultural, which they usually have less fees, and like it's different than like Greek Life. It's like Greek Life, but it's not Panhellenic, if that makes sense. So it's not like AD Pi or Alpha Phi or anything like that. It's like they have their own names and they're multicultural, and I don't know if they have cuts or not, but like I know they're not Panhellenic. So if you're wanting to get involved and you don't really want to be in Panhellenic, that's another option for you. But going to Rush is going to experience, like, you're just gonna get the experience. You're not gonna feel like you've missed out. It's literally like $50 and it's worth it, because you make so many friends, you see the whole thing out, and then you just don't take a bid. And it's kind of, that sounds really bad to say, but like at the end of the day, like it's your experience. And if you end up finding a sorority that you wanna be in, it's great. But if you don't, you don't feel like you've, you know, wasted your time either, because you got to experience it, and you're not gonna feel like you missed out on an opportunity, because as a freshman it's so much easier to go through Rush than any other year. Getting involved in clubs and work study is really good for your resume, so if you are looking to like build up the resume, do that. The other thing is, not all frat parties are what you see in the news or what you read about, because at the end of the day, like, there are good frats and there's bad frats at every single college. There could be one frat that everyone hates here at ASU, but they're like, ah, whatever, at another, you know, college. Or people might love them at another college. It just depends. So at the end of the day, like, don't read into things. Like, go experience it for yourself. Don't ever drink from cups, though, that, like, aren't fully sealed. Bring your own. If you're going to be drinking alcohol, bring your own alcohol. That's one thing I have to say, because at the end of the day, like, you don't want to be that person that gets roofied at a party or anything like that. Be smart when you're out and about and having fun, but have fun. There are so many good frats to party at. Girls obviously get in for free. Guys don't really get in, so like the girl to guy ratio is a little bit different, but you know, it's fun. And then party with a good group of friends that you actually trust. Don't just go with a group that you're just like, oh, I don't know if Katrina's gonna take care of me when I get drunk tonight. Like, be certain that you're with people that you trust and make sure they're gonna keep you safe. Okay, now on to school. So when I'm talking about school, I'm such a big advocate of work hard, play hard. Like, if you want to work really hard and you want to like earn, you know, your degree, but like still play hard, like totally go out and do that. Like, I think it's really important to remember you are going to college to have an education. The first 2 years, though, are honestly like prereqs. Like, a lot of the time you're not taking the super hard upper division classes, you're just chilling, like you can have some fun. But just remember, like, the study habits you're implementing your freshman and sophomore year, you're gonna have to take through your junior and senior year. When you're starting off in these classes, if you guys are watching this now and you guys haven't like started your classes yet and you're like getting ready, you're getting pumped, one of the biggest things that I wanna say is make sure that you introduce yourself after, you know, class is over or before class, so that the professors know who you are on the first week. And then go into their office hours. I usually go into their office hours like a month into school, because by that point, you know, things have settled down a little bit. The teachers are like, okay, like, they see you in class, they see you working hard, but when you go into office hours and say, hey, like, I just want to make sure that my grade is going to be the best thing it can possibly be, it's a month into school, so they're like, okay, this isn't like the last moment, this is like almost halfway through, and you're checking up, and that's good. And then you're gonna be reminding them of who they are, because sometimes they have hundreds of students or thousands of students and they don't really care about who you are, but if you go in, then they'll remember you. Third thing is to sit in the front of the class, because if you're sitting in the front, then they see your face all the time, they know who you are, and you're just more like noticeable and they're more aware, and then you're actually going to be forced to pay attention, because I think that's one of the biggest things. Like, everyone I know, they're like, I always sit in the back and I fall asleep in class, I'm not paying attention. I'm like, you should really sit in the front, because at the end of the day, they'll notice you more. My grades are higher than my friends are because I sit in the front of my classes. The next thing is to go for tutoring at least once. At least at Arizona State University, we have free tutoring, so you can go into the tutoring center. People that are, you know, really good at that subject tutor you, and it's a perfect opportunity to show that you care, because a lot of the times your professors can see if you've gone in for tutoring. Like, they'll ask, what have you done? And you can say, I've gone in for tutoring. I've studied the amount of time that you say I should, like, blah, blah, blah. And then the moment that you say that you've gone for tutoring, that shows the extra amount of effort you've put in. Plus, a lot of the times the people in there are super helpful, and like, even if you just are doing homework in there, they'll help you with it. Find a group to study with, because then you're gonna be doing homework or studying with people that it'll be a lot funner, and then you'll also, funner is not even a word, am I even in college? But anyways, you find a group of people to study with that you like, because at the end of the day, those people are most likely gonna be your friends. And then it'll turn into like a nice organic created friendship, you know? Because for me at least, like, the people that I study with, I usually go out and do other things with too. And we're really good friends. And like, if they can do homework with you, then they can do the other things, like the things that are a lot more fun. And if you can have fun doing homework with them, more power to you. If you guys have group work in some of your classes, make sure that you are always put with people that you know are more intelligent and smart and like hardworking. They don't even need to be the smartest, but like, as long as they're hardworking and they like do their work, you're going to have a much better group work project. Because I know for chemistry and biology, if you're in one of those classes, make sure that you sit with your lab group and like try and sit with people that you think are like smarter. Because I'm gonna be honest with you, I dropped chem because I'm not saying my chem group wasn't smart, but like, I knew that I was gonna end up being the one that was doing all the work, and like, I'm not that great at chem as it is, so I didn't want to be doing all of that. I'd rather have like more time, you know, to do my stuff, so I'm taking that this summer. But make sure that you are set up with a good group, because if you're not with a good group, you're gonna be doing all the work, you're gonna be the one that's like, you know, you're just, trust me on it, find a good group for anything that you're doing. It'll make it a lot easier. And the last thing that I want to say though is, don't stress, it'll all be okay. Because at the end of the day, like, if you're stressing over something, your mind isn't going to be clear, you're not gonna be able to get things done. But if you're just like letting yourself go through the motion and like do it, it's a lot better than stressing. And then you're not gonna have like the freshman 15, because when you're stressed out, your body gains weight and you don't get enough sleep, and it just turns into a vicious cycle. So remember to like deep breathe and not stress, and know that like, these classes, if you're trying, it'll all work out. And like, your grades are grades, they don't define you. C's get degrees. Not that I'm saying C's are gonna get you very far with your degree, but like, just remember that like, one class that you have that grade in that you're not okay with shouldn't cost your mental health, you know? So make sure to focus on your mental health too, and don't forget to have fun, because college is all about like experiencing new things. Your parents are finally out of like being all over you, and just know that it's a good time. If you're getting stressed out, just sit in your room for a little bit. Remember to take breaks, take care of yourself, don't party every day. Like, I know a lot of people go crazy the first couple of weeks, you know, but like, just remember that like, you're gonna have the whole year to party, so like, don't stress out if you're not partying enough in the beginning. Like, you will find people that'll want to. Everyone parties. Like, you will see someone, you'll be like, I bet they don't party, and they do. But then there's also people that like, you think party and they don't. And so it's like one of those things where it's like, everyone can do what they want in college. Like, if you're looking for a group to party with, find some friends and they'll most likely go out with you, and make sure that they're ones that'll take care of you. That's kind of my how to have an amazing college experience from my point of view, when it comes to friends, school, and everything else. But I love you guys so much. So I'm gonna end the video here. If you guys liked this, then don't forget to give it a like. Don't forget to subscribe. Next Monday, I'm going to be doing a college Q&A. So if you guys wanna leave me college questions down below, I would really, really appreciate it, because you know, your girl is going to be doing a college Q&A and I wanna answer questions that you guys have. I know this video didn't answer everything and there's probably so many things you guys have questions about, but feel free to comment those down below. I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye, babe.